Hi guys, Gray here. Got a bit of a bad weather today, it just rained. But this yellow glasses really works when it's kind of dark outside and raining. Well, I just couldn't help myself. Need to go stumping with the... Here it comes. And I know there's a couple of you who guessed right. It is a William Reeve Boyer's name from Eugenia Custom Bows. So, absolutely wonderful bow. I'm really having a blast. And especially because it's pointing exactly as I want them to. I'm just looking at things and just throwing away arrows. It's like the three-part shooting with the mystery. Man, check out how fast I shoot those five arrows. Man, I'm just throwing them away. It's so easy. And I'm really starting to know this one now. So I'm at Stump Heaven, guys, so I thought I'd take you with me on a little tour around, see what we can find regarding stumps. There's a nice one just about there. I'm gonna back off a little bit. It's a better picture, I noticed, but almost went through there. I'm gonna put one to the left of that one, a little higher. A little higher in between. Goes right through. These are soft, eh? Yeah, it's the one I shot the first arrow when I made a 7-arrow zombie run. It's kind of soft, yep. It goes right through. But man, this bow gives me so much confidence. Kind of instantly, the first arrow I shot, it's like, man, I don't even have any doubts that I'm gonna hit it. I know I'm going to hit it, so. I think I need to just film all the time and don't close the camera. Even if I do that, it still makes them into two parts, the films. But it seems like my batteries are holding up for longer when I don't shut it off. I don't know. Maybe the starting procedure takes so long, so I got some water drops on the camera. Oh, I hope it don't make you weary. I'm gonna do some shots. See if we can. Hope you can see this. But I have a twig in front of me, exactly in front of me, so I need to put the camera somewhere else, man. It doesn't work. Look, can I put it on the ground here? Yep. These new glasses I have, as I said before, they're like binoculars. I can't really see close up with them. But man, I could read a book from that stump there. I was thinking about something. These silences are not, well, they're kind of all like nothing, but if I took some of my fly tying wax on them, they get a little heavier. Maybe they work better. I just thought, just to try, if that makes any difference, but I forgot to do that, of course. Well, I am gray for a reason. Oh man, this is... It's so easy to shoot. And I really think, doesn't matter what kind of bow, brand, or what you order, you should get a grip that's kind of high like this one, because, well, there's very, very few guys, archers, that can shoot well like I do. And I prefer to hold the bow real steady with a very low grip. And, well, kind of when I got my Acadian, I understood that. So that is kind of a high grip, but in the same time it's made so I can really grip the bow. And this one really convinced me that it's very, very thick, but it just sits in my hand so nicely. So, man, I just love that. So, let's find another one. Hey man, sometimes I'm telling you that you need a challenge in your life. Oh, I got one for me. There's a really nice stump in front of a massive rock stone, but I can't really put the camera anywhere. It's a bad thing. Let's see. Can I hang it on here? Oh, thank you. I'll see you anyway. And I can't see. Not with these glasses on, so... Ooh, I think you see that one now, hey? Or are you? No, no, no. Stump is way over there. No, it doesn't work, man. Let's see if we can find somewhere else to put it. Here's something. Man, this wasn't good, eh? Here, then. Here, we should be able to make it. Can you get that? No, no, no. Man, what's this? What's out of here? Oh, that would be nice if it would be kind enough to stay still. Sit, boo-boo, sit. Oops, 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 oops. You see the stump on the rock? Well, the thing is, if that stump is too soft, they're gonna hit the rock behind it, but, well, let's find out with one of the arrows, man. Perfect shot right in the crack. That's the way Gray likes him, eh? Let's put another one there. Ooh! That's one of them semi-soft stumpies. It bounced off it like it was made of rubber, man. But the first one is perfect. And I really like these challenging shots sometimes. Oh, it was a full stump. Looks like it was a half only. But... And it stopped raining. Thank you for that, mother. So guys, mother nature, do we have something more? Ooh, there's a nice one. But that is kind of, ooh, that's a hard one. There's just too many things in the way. Oh, can I get low? No, I can't. The arrow's arc's gonna hit the... Hey, that was a nice one. If I go right, then it's gonna be even thicker with all these twigs. I thought I'd go up another direction, another way. Find some new stumps. There's a new one, nice one too, but it's just too close, man. Ooh, look what we got here. Almost too easy. But I still got some twigs to be careful of. See that? It's like a street. There's something pretty dark in the middle of the stump. Oh, mosquitoes are alive. So, what can we do with that one? Ooh, it's a long way. Oh, I need to shoot it in the hole to get the arrow to stick there. So it's usually softer down. And let's shoot in the hole. No, we don't. Great, concentrate. Like that. I really don't think it's in the hole, but well, pretty darn close. Four in it and one bounce off, and it's right there in the dark spot. Man, that's great. Oops, sorry. Man, the mosquitoes are starting to bugger me. Oh, ants are starting to build something in this old one. Man, this is quite hard. Well, man, I'm so impressed with the bow. Not to mention my arrows. It's sick how tough these GT treads are, man. Really, seriously. I've been shooting for a couple of years with them, but I don't know, they still kind of blew me away, because, man, sometimes I just shoot and the stump is so incredibly hard. And it's like it doesn't matter. But I wonder if it weakens the arrow, if it cracks, like some of the strands, one or two every time I shoot in something so hard, and then suddenly it breaks, so kind of wear them out. So, because I really do wear my Swiki Judos out, man, I should really need a sponsorship from the Swikis. I thrashed three now this springtime, because, well, it was the ones that was left from last summer, so, but still, three is gone, so I only got these five left, so I need more soon, because I think these are equally old, so they're gonna break one by one any time now. So the thing is that there's a little pine cord just above the stump hanging, and that is gonna be 15 plus meters away, and that is not a big one, but man, can I take it down? I got five arrows, man. Let's try that. So forget about the stump. I wonder if you see the, let's see, can you see the little if you do that. It's just one above. I don't know if it's really visible in this. Hard time finding it with the camera. It should be right on top of the right on top of the stump. Oh, you saw that? Oh man, if I was a hunter, that bird would be gone. It's gonna be 25, 30 meters away from me now. I don't know exactly where it is, but I'll let them live. Well, the twig above it is gone. And that was a thick one too. Right off. Oh man, saw that? That is gone. Oh man. I love it when a bow allows me to do things like that, man. It's just like the ultimate confirmation that this bow is fantastic. Man, that was sick. Oh, it's so, I mean, it should not be possible with a new bow, man. It's the third time I'm shooting with it. And I do things like that, man, that I only do with my Acadian. It's just something with this cutout that really fits great. So. Man, I really took that. You can see the twig I shot off first. That's a thick one. That's a equally big pine cone. I just love this one. So, it's really sick, man. When a bow is made really to fit me, and I can shoot like this. And but you know, I've been shooting a lot of different bows, and they all are very similar, and although so different. And it's just one thing is that it doesn't matter what bow it is, even if some bow maker, I think even if Tim made 5 custom-made bows, I still think I would need a different length of arrows to each one of them, because it's just how the wood plays along with the glass fiber, carbon, whatever it's in the bow, tillering and everything. You just can't make a custom bow exactly the same. And therefore it's so incredibly important to do the bear shaft testing. So I don't know, guys are trying to ask me questions and I just can't answer them, because you need to do the bear shaft test, because you need to find out what's wrong before I can tell you what you to do. So, and the bear shaft test just tells you everything, man. So if you haven't done the bear shaft test, sorry guys, there's like no meaning to even ask me until you've done that one, because, and I mean, 99.9% of all the questions I get, you got the answers in my film. So I know there's starting to get quite a few films in there, but sometimes or many times the name of the film kind of tells you if it's the right one. So stop blathering, man, and shoot. A small hole in that stump, and it just got bigger. Ooh, it's a softy. Let's put one a little to the left, a little higher. Ah, that was harder, yeah. And a little to the right of that one. There. Man, I can't guide the arrows already. Serious. And I can't tell you, new glasses that I see everything with, well, they really help too, man. I'll put you there on a stump. You can contemplate on life and look at the forest. Ooh. And what do I see before me? Easy stump. Well, I don't have to walk far to find stumps on this one. In this forest, guys, because they're half rotten and they are everywhere. There's one little leaf in the middle that kind of sticks out from the crowd, so to speak. And it wasn't there. Ooh, getting close. I don't like when arrows hit sideways on the stump. I need to shoot lower. Or I'll trash that arrow. It's a good thing that didn't came that much rain, so it's not that wet outside. So, what do we find then? We have a little pond. Swimming pool here in the... I think I've shown you that before, but let's go there. Oh man, that really sits in there. So, I can tell you I have something coming that's gonna help me remove these judo point arrows from stumps very quickly and much easier than ever before. And you know what? It was a while back, I got confirmation that I kind of got confirmation about what my review films do for Boyers. And guys, well, I want to thank you too, because you're spreading all the videos, but man, it's kind of mind-blowing. They have sold hundreds of bows. I mean hundreds. Like 400 or 500 bows sold or in a queue. Archers waiting for them because of the reviews I do, so oh man, that feels like absolutely wonderful. It's for me, it's a confirmation that it works, that I get the word out, so to speak, about the bows, that they are good to buy. And well, I know when you're a newbie or you don't know anything about a bow, man, putting down $500 to $1,000 on a bow and you don't know anything about it, man, that's tough. So I thought, like, well, if I was in kind of your place and saw like me or someone else doing a review and doing different review, different bows and shooting with it like I do, man, I mean, that would really settle it for me, man, to buy or not to buy. But it's just fantastic. So, and of course, selling a lot of bows because of my reviews has spread out, so there are bows coming in just these couple of days. I got two new more coming, so oh man, I hope every boyer understands how important it is, because this is just not a review, written review in some kind of magazine or some kind of site that's going to disappear anytime, because this is YouTube, man. Man, that's gonna be there for what? Forever, 100 years. It's ridiculous. Man, what's that worth in money? It's just ridiculous. So, yeah, boyers, this is the biggest chance, the best thing you can do to spread the word about your bows, is to send me one, make me do a review about it. So, well, think about it, and if you still are unsure, man, give the other ones a call. Call them and ask them how it went after they made a review of their bows. So Enough blathering again, I'm just talking. A lot of crap, eh? Man, 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 where are them stumps? Of course, they're everywhere, but... Well, I don't like them if they're too easy. Need to take something a little bit more challenging. Man, the grass is really light green with these yellow lenses. And I can just imagine how animals see things in the forest, because, man, I can zoom in on a spot like 100 meters from here, it feels like. Oh, I got a really, really difficult one. But, man, that's what I love. I hope you can see that. I don't know if you can even zoom in on it, it's quite far away. I don't know even where it is. Oh, it's so far away. Is that one? And ho, I got twigs and things and stuff in the way here. just starting to wonder if I can even make that at all, but man, there's nothing behind it. So thing is that I think I need to shoot with the camera. It's not good. Can I see if I can't get that to show again, man? So it's, I think it's, is it that one? No. Is not, is that one? Ooh. See if the camera stays still, because I'm gonna shoot like just beside the camera. I'm gonna put my arse down on a stone here, on a rock. And I don't think I'm gonna shoot more than one arrow, because. Ooh. Okay. Cameraman's drunk again, man. You're still there? Yep. I need to take that shot fast before you fall down, so. Who's. I gotta shoot like between two. It's like a fork with sticks, so. Oh, that's a crappy one. But I'm. I got a real crappy sit here. Hit a twig and shot over. Oh, of course I hit it when a camera fall down. There's one arrow in there. Oh man. Sometimes it's like, it really doesn't matter if I have a, if I just have a path where I can put the arrow in and shoot it. It's if I'm sitting or standing, real, real awkward like I was now. That really puts me off. Because I like, totally missed first arrow. Bad release and bad thing. Well, I got the tree, eh? These fresh trees are. Doesn't go that deep. This wicked deer is easy to take out, and I don't damage the tree that much either. So. Oh, there's no water off. There's nothing left here. There's usually a little pond here. And the animals really been drinking there, but man, as I said, we have like 25, 27 degrees plus for a week, and it kind of really dries out the wood, so. Oh. Targets. Haha. Louis knows what I mean. Louis Likiema. Or something like it. So, guys. Let's go downhill. It's little bit difficult to walk here now when he's cut down these smaller trees here. Oh, well, 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 well. I think a week or two and I'm gonna have a hard time seeing the stumps. Man, squirrels being busy. So, can we find something funny? Oh, that was an ant farm. I was almost about to stick my camera pod in there. It's not a good idea. So. It really changes the forest, how it's looking when it's starting to get green again after being so brown and dead after the winter time. So well, I'm just walking around looking stupid, guys. I need to shoot at something. And the mosquito is starting to like me. I don't know if you can see that. I got three stumps here. Uno, due, tre. One, two, and three behind it. Let's put one each. Ooh, cut the leaf.
Yes.
I just cut the leaf in two that I was looking at. And I cut that straw. And I got a crack on the third one there, but that's far away, man. Oh, I think I hit the crack. It was a hard crack. Oh, that just those shots really makes me worry. Is that arrow going to be in one piece? Ooh. Oh man, I really need a better retractor for the 60-0s. Like it's stone hard, that stump, and the arrow is just in one piece. Just ridiculous, man. So, what else and what more? Where do they hide? Where art thou? Brother, where art thou? Here's a nice one too. Got a big mother of a stump. It's been growing on a big rock. So, yep, that's a challenge, man. Love that. See if I can put you somewhere behind me. Is this just too far? Yeah, I don't see nothing. So, but this one then. No. I'll put you guys once again on a tree. I got one of those spider legs. So I think you see that, right? Legs, camera holder, but well, it's so difficult just to adjust it every time. I think I swallowed one of those mosquitoes. And they don't even taste good. So guys, don't shoot at the stone, Gray, if I hit a twig. And it goes low. That's a big rock. I can tell you that arrow is gone. Oh man, was that the crappiest shot ever. Just because I'm standing so idiotically. Oh, I hit the branch. I need to go in alone. I'm dead to shooting.
That was a good example of what I was talking about earlier. Standing really badly makes you miss, so it's good to train on different kind of stance, but well, you kind of can't exaggerate them and make them too bad, the stand. So I got an arrow, somewhere, but I can tell you this orange, I always, mosquitoes haunting me, this, well, you see, it's quite easy to see this orange, doesn't really look that good, but man, I'm glad if they fly straight and I can find them. It's like the main thing. The camera's still working, man. The battery really holds up much, much better when I'm not closing the camera. I got a nice one there. See if you can see that. Oh, I got a bend it too. See there? There is a stump. There. Gonna shoot a little bit on the side. One low. One very close to where I was looking at. And one where I was looking at. There's some leaves just to the left of the arrow. Let's go higher, left. Oh, there was a twig just. Almost hit my own arrow. It's just so easy to shoot with this bow. The thing is, when a bow really suits you, well, at least suits me, it's kind of so effortless. I just look at things and just shoot, man. That is kind of why I really love this instinctive shooting, because man, when I was competing with a compound release, all the gadgets, man, before I lined up everything, got my breathing right and released it, man, I had a headache like after 5 arrows. It's just so intensive. So it kind of took away a lot of the fun shooting with a bow, because it's like it's too much work behind it. And I was starting to think why, because it's just so easy with a trad bow, man. You just look at the thing you want to hit and shadam, there it is. I got a nice stump there, but I can't put you anywhere, can I? No. Oh, come on. That would be a nice. Let's see if I can. No. Just behind them. Hello. But you see the stumps just everywhere. But well, I just kind of tried to find something a little bit more difficult. Challenging, because I got a bow that's
up to it, so the bow that's up to the challenge. Let's go in the thickness of the forest. But if I put you down, man, you don't see anything. Uphill or just behind a little rice ridge isn't a good place to shoot. Oh, there's a nice one. Wonder if we can. I just can't put you. Oh, there's one. Oh, that's a hard one. Yep. That one we gotta try. It's a small stump, but man, has a nice dark hole in it. There's twigs and things in the way. Just above the camera, but yeah, I can shoot between there. Ooh, the arrow lies a little bit sideways, man. Don't like that. So I need to shoot a bit higher. Like there. Oh man, this bow really pleases me. Let's try to put something on the left side. No, that's a bad release, bad release. On the left side, I think it went right through. So, guys and gals, and especially William Reeves, Eugenia Custom Bows, man, I take my hat off for you. You really succeeded with this one. And man, I love the fact that you really been attention, paying attention to what I like about bows and made a bow that kind of is like a gray archer special. And turn out to be so wonderful. Man, I absolutely love that. Man, be proud. Because you have a reason to be. And you guys, especially you Europeans, because this man lives in Germany. Yes, he's from Canada, I think. And he's been building boats like from started at 82, I think. So he's done a few. So he knows what he's doing. And well,